Charles?
Davey!
Long time no see. How are you, old chap?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Just fine.
What's up?
Well, as you know, I've been trying to get my business off the ground for a while now, and I think I'm finally ready to launch.
Oh, nice. So it's hairspray. Oh,
Davey, it's much more. This spray could keep you from paying a barber for the rest of your life.
It's taken months of careful crafting just to make the prototype. Are you still working at the library?
No. I quit like a month ago. Are you?
Oh, not much anymore. All my time's been going to this. It could be the next big thing. And if you're free, I want you to be a part of it.
You want me to help you start your business?
You're in business school. Isn't that what you're here for? Listen, Davey, you're a smart guy. You just need something to get passionate about.
You still have my number, right? Give me a call. Don't expect you to devote your life, but I think this could be good for you. Right on time, Davey. The students are over there. Are you okay taking pictures?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Good. Let's get started. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being a part of our test group today. I want you to visualize a world, much like our own, but without the existence of a barber shop. Instead, you only have this. I know it sounds far-fetched, but this spray will keep hair from growing and leave you feeling just as refreshed. Now, if you could move your chairs into a straight line. My first question to you is, how does it feel?
Feels kind of greasy.
Yo, dude!
What the hell?
Deeply sorry, chap. I thought it would be a better shot if I massaged it in myself.
What? Why would you do that?
This is only a trial run of my spray. You don't have to be so rude.
Listen, I don't feel comfortable doing this anymore. Ah, damn it! Ah, what is that stuff?
Hey, this stuff will change lives.
Charles, what were you thinking?
What I did was wrong. I have issues with my anger, Davey. I apologize that you had to see that. It's something that I'm working on.
You assaulted that man.
And I will apologize to the students for that. Listen, I'm sorry.
Gentlemen, I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
Davey, please, I still need your help.
I don't know, man.
Listen, I've got a meeting with an investor tomorrow morning. He could give me a lot of money. You can't back out now. I know it's cliche, but networking really is key. Could you come for like 30 minutes?
I'll come. But you better not pull anything like that again.
Thank you. I won't, Davey, I promise. Can I pick you up around 10?
Sure.
And don't forget to send me those photos. Nobody goes to Mervis Hall on Sundays.
Hey, Charles.
Good to see you, Brian. This is my friend Davey. He helped me with the experiment yesterday.
Nice to meet you, Davey. I'm Brian.
Nice to meet you.
Please, sit down. So, how'd the experiment go?
There's still a lot to figure out, but we definitely got some initial interest. Here's the prototype.
Wow! I like the design.
I also made a video.
Good work. This stuff is really potent. You mind if I take this bottle? My dad's been itching to see what you guys came up with.
Oh, your dad. He's the investor.
Oh, Charles didn't tell you? My dad works for the Pittsburgh Innovation Institute. I was gonna see if he'd help him develop his prototype.
I'm confused. I heard there was an investor. Who are you?
Oh, I'm president of the Entrepreneurs Club. Charles is an outstanding member. I'm sure my dad will give you some great feedback. Then you guys will be on your way to finding investors in no time.
Wow. What a complete waste of my time.
Please, I was looking out for you.
How? This entire business isn't real. You're wasting my time.
Oh, Davey. This whole time I thought I could help you, but you're inconsolable.
Excuse me?
I'm not stupid, Davey. What employer would hire you? That video nearly got you expelled. You were a good guy, but your behavior needed to change. I thought about it constantly, and eventually I decided I would be the one to change it. Frankly, I became obsessed with you.
What are you talking about?
You left your email open at work, Davey. After you left, I couldn't stop checking it. When I saw you were interviewing at Robin's Financial, I snapped. You were handed that interview. You didn't deserve it.
You sent them that video. My only interview in 3 months, and you sent them that! Who do you think you are?
Please, Davey, I gave you an opportunity.
I had an opportunity!
So let me start by saying, here at Robbins Financial, we like to hold ourselves to a higher standard. Our philosophy is that what we do is a reflection of who we are, and we like to compete. We like to win. Are you a winner, Davey?
Well, sir, I'd like to think so.
That's good, that's good. I've known your father for many years, so I know you come from good stock. And to be honest with you, that's the only reason you're here. Your resume really is not that great. So tell me, Davey, what makes you a go-getter? Why should I bring Davey Kade to Robbins Financial?
For me, college has been all about being a go-getter. Hard work, determination, a positive state of mind. I use all of it in my undergraduate studies. A perfect example was in a statistics class that I took,
Just a second, Davey. Yes? Okay, can it wait? Alright, I'll take a look at it now.
Is there a problem, Mr. Robbins?
Are you recording?
Yeah.
Dude, that bus is soaked.
I don't think we're going to move forward with you, Mr. Kade.
You're a psychopath. If you ever contact me again, I'll get the cops involved.
Everything all right, man?
I'm fine.
Charles, what are you doing here?
Davey, I've slaved away my entire life thinking I had to work hard to make my dreams a reality.
Charles, stop pouring that!
I've made a product no one cares about, Davey. I'm a failure. This was all for nothing.
I know you're mad. You have every right to be. But that business would have failed either way, and you know it. That's okay. We're young. You know, we make mistakes.
Don't give me that crap. Your actions have consequences, and it's time you learned that.
There's a secret to this spray, Davey. It contains trace amounts of a highly toxic element, which, in perfect dosages, burns hair follicles without causing permanent damage. However, it has a violent aroma and causes mild dizziness. That element is arsenic, and coincidentally, it's very flammable.